Today's video lecture will start second part of the chapter, the mad visitor. And in the previous video we came to know that when Orcible was busy with talking to his guest and receiving him in the room, as he opened the door there was in advance someone available in the room, and it was quite startling thing for anyone that the room is locked from outside and there is someone inside earlier. And he was a new person, a villain has entered in the story called Max, who was again a secret agent, and he demands for that piece of paper, that very important document from Orcible, and pranks on him, calling that paper would be more safe in his hand than in Orcible's. And how Orcible proves his intelligence on him, and why did he describe the balcony in detail, or why did he open the balcony episode? Let's find it. So when he demands for paper, Orcible moved to an armchair and sat down very heavily. Heavily means in a very sorrowful mood. And he said something very grimly. Grimly means very serious and serious tone. This is the second time in the month that somebody has got into my room, means Orcible's room. And Fowler's eyes went to the single window. Fowler means the writer. Here, the writer who has come to take interview of Orcible. So he saw there was really a single window of the room, and it was an ordinary window against which now the night was pressing blackly. Means you can see through that balcony that there was night. That was quite black balcony. So he asked the question. Who asked the question? Means Orcible. And he was talking about, he means Orcible was talking about balcony. So Max asked the question, balcony, and then he tells one more information. No, a pass key. Means Max tells him that he had entered the room through the pass key, not through the balcony. Pass key means he had his own private key, master key. Thieves have such master keys, you know, that they can open any lock. And I did not know about the balcony. Means he did not know anything about balcony, even though Orcible intentionally opened the chapter of balcony episode. So there was some intention behind it. So let's find out why. And you see, it's not my balcony, Orcible said with extreme irritation. It belongs to the next apartment. He glanced up exploratingly at Fowler. You see, he said, this room used to be a part of a large unit. And the next room, means this balcony is of other room. Now, Max glanced at Fowler, and that was standing stiffly. Stiffly means in a very straight manner. And Max said to him, please sit down. He pointed the gun towards him and said, we have a wait of half an hour, I think. Means he said to Fowler that you will be bothered here for only half an hour. When I will have the document, I will go. 31 minutes, Orcible said. And you can see while Orcible was busy with him talking, he engaged him in talking, and he looks very confident. He intentionally said 31 minutes. It proves that he may be knowing what will happen afterward. Means Orcible knows everything. That's why he said 31 minutes. Actually, you are not correct. So by correcting Max, he just tried to win his or triumph over his confusion, and he proves himself to be confident. So he's corrected him. Actually, you are wrong, and it's 31. It is just to make the talk light. And Orcible said very in a moody way, the appointment was for 12:30, and I wish I knew how you learned about the report, Max. And he said that how could you know about the report? Means this way he was just killing the time, because from Orcible's side there may be something fixed program that what will happen after half an hour or 30 minutes. Will someone enter or not? He may be knowing it. So that's why he intentionally put this point there. So now, that's why he said, I wish, means he wanted to know how Max could know about the report. The little spy smiled evilly. Means little means he may be a kind of not a very tall fellow. It was discussed earlier and he smiled in an evil manner. And he said, I will get it back tonight. What is that? Who is at the door? And as he spoke to Ossible, there was some knocking at the door. And Fowler jumped at the sudden knocking, because there was sudden knocking, and Fowler, the writer, he was not doing anything. But maybe Ossible knew everything about this, why the knocking was there. So Fowler jumped out of surprise, and Ossible said with a smile that it would be police. And what did he say? I thought that such an important paper is the one we are waiting for, should have a little extra protection. And he said that he means Ossible told police to have a check on him, because he is carrying a very important document those days. So this way he threatens or he frightens Max that the person who is knocking outside his room right now at then or there may be police. And definitely this will increase his level of confidence and will definitely decrease the level of confidence of new another fellow called Max. Now, Max bit his lip nervously, and you can see that Max is very nervous now, and the knocking was repeated again and again. What will you do now, Max? Ossible asked. If I do not answer the door, if I will not open the door, not talk with that fellow, they would enter in the room, and the door is even unlocked. So he tells everything. Told the balcony in detail, and that way he gave him idea when he would return in any kind of danger, through which way he should go. He told him the idea, and next time he told him that it may be police, and if I will not open the door, they will themselves enter in the room and will see the scene. So this way he made Max frightened. Now Max's face was black with anger, and he just backed swiftly towards the window. Means he goes backward and towards the window. He wanted to save his life now. He wanted to hide himself first from the police. That's why he started going to window place now, that is balcony here. And who gave him this idea to go through balcony? Ossible himself. So initially you may be finding him such a poor fellow, why he gave this idea to him. So he swung a leg over the sill, and he put his one leg on the stone of that balcony and sent them away. And he said to Ossible that he should send police away, and he gave them warning that he would wait in the balcony, and after they would be sent outside, he will come back and will take his chances, means he will take his documents. The knocking at the door became louder, and the voice was raised. Mr. Ossible, means someone was calling Ossible from outside. Now, keeping his body twisted so that his gun still covered the fat man. His gun was still covering the fat man, and he knew who is fat man. It is Ossible and his guest, that is Fowler. The man at the window grasped the frame with his free hand. So he tried to grasp it, understand if there is anything to put the leg or not. And then he free his hand. Then he left his hand from where he was holding the support, and he just gave all the weight toward the balcony side. Then he swung his other leg up and over the windowsill. The doorknob turned. Swiftly, Max pushed with his left hand and to free himself, and he dropped in the sill, means that stone, a big platform or stone type in the balcony. And then as he dropped, he screamed once. You can make a guess You can make an idea why he screamed once only, and that was a shrill, means a very heavy pitched tone. Means he shouted once, means with a very sharp sound, and once, why once only? There may be a strong reason behind it. He must have gone very down, just below the building, and must have injured heavily. The door opened and a waiter stood there with a tray, a bottle and two glasses. Here is the drink you ordered for when you returned. So he fixed the person, he told the waiter to bring the drink. That's why he says that 31 minutes only in the initial talk. And it was a waiter, simply no police. And Ossible knew it. Even after knowing this, he said it may be police outside. So that was his brain actually. And he very quickly, deftly means very quickly, he uncorked, opened the bottle and left the room. White-faced Fowler. Fowler's face was white, means out nervous, out of seeing this all scene. Someone pointed a gun towards you, threatening you to kill you. And after some time, he goes outside and there was no police. A servant came. Definitely, it was not less than a kind of drama, kind of episode you see in some thrillers. It really happened true today in his life here. So, but he stammered, the police, means what about the police? And there were no police, Ossible said, only Henry. Who was this fellow? Henry. So there is fourth character in the story, that is Henry. Henry's role is very important again here, though it's very small role, whom I was expecting, and he was expecting him to come. That's why he knew this, and that's why he very confidently said it may be police. And he tricked the mind of Max. But won't that man out in the balcony? He is narrator. Narrator still feels that that Max would be there. So he says, will that fellow not come again? That he warned him he will come back and take his chance. No, said Ossible. He won't return. You see, my young friend, there is no balcony. Actually, there was no balcony. But still he calls it, there is a balcony and one can easily comes in his room and bothers him a lot. So he intentionally put the balcony episode there. And really there was no balcony. It was his trick, and that was proved successful on Max, his competent, his enemy. So Ossible is a secret agent here. He looks though very ordinary, but he proves himself very perfect for his job. He's fit for his job, even though the enemy was having pistol and all, but he tricked him so well, and he told intentionally the balcony episode so that he would get the idea while going back through the balcony, and he just get rid of his enemy. So it shows that how intelligent he was. He did not lose his heart in the situation of troubles. His mind worked very perfectly. We call it presence of mind, and he had very good capability of thinking very immediately, that he gave a trick to he could give a trick to his enemy called Max, who is again a secret agent, but he in fact seems to be very foolish here. He wants to seize the paper, but Ossible proves too intelligent for him. And he describes the balcony in detail, while in fact there was no balcony. The foolish Max believes every word of it. And Ossible was confident. He did not lose heart. So he turned the topic from paper to balcony episode and then police. This consumed his half an hour, and it was the time of coming of that servant. And it helped him a lot. So this way he never... Max very practically knows nothing about the place, and he has to pay for this foolishness in this story. So one should never lose the heart, one should never lose his wit, his patience while dealing with some panic situations. So his method of quick thinking here, immediately thinking, gave him a wonderful chance to dodge his enemy here. I hope you must have enjoyed the story. Thank you for attending it, and you will be given assignment for completing the NCERT exercise. Please do that. Thank you.